To the show. I'm so happy that you have joined me for this particular episode of Babbie's House, because today's guest is a mighty woman of God. Dr. Deborah Isom, first of all, is a woman of great vision, and she sees well beyond the square space in which she lives. She sees according to the needs of the world, beginning with her community and her region and her country, and then to the uttermost parts of the world. And isn't that what the Bible tells us that we must do? And she is carrying out the Great Commission. And I want you all to welcome to the show Dr. Deborah Isom. Hello, my friend. It's so good to see you. I know that's right. I love you. God has allowed you to launch a beautiful ministry called Begin Again.
Yes.
And Deborah, you're in the trenches. You are down where the rubber really meets the road.
Where
hands get dirty.
Yeah.
And sometimes people don't smell so good, and the hungry and the lost and
That's
the dying
right.
and the next
yeah.
generation.
Yeah, yeah.
Tell us about Begin Again Ministry.
I will do that. You know, we've been doing a lot of things through the ministry. Was really established in 2002, and we started by opening a Bible school, and we did some things with that, and we're still kind of doing that, training ministers and things like that. But the Lord, I was just walking around in my kitchen one day, and the Lord said to me, he said, feed the homeless.
Mm-hmm.
And I said to myself, I said, Lord, okay, how am I going to do that? You know, how am I going to feed the homeless? And he said, start with what you have. And what we had was some bottled water.
Mm-hmm.
So we went downtown and we started just distributing water in the summer to some of the people on the streets, you know. And so the Lord said, you know, he wanted me to do more. So we then began to make sandwiches, and we took them out, you know, to the homeless with the water. And then the Lord said, do more. So we started, you know, buying food and just making meals. And as I began to tell people about what we were doing, then we got a group of people started coming out, and we started doing, you know, maybe once a month, but now it's expanded and we're feeding all the time. So that's what the Lord told me to do. And he told me this, he said, you know, if we don't touch the lives of the less fortunate, then they think they've been abandoned by God. But the Lord said, his hands can't touch in this realm, but ours can.
Yes.
And if we don't begin to do something to make a difference in the lives of the less fortunate, then they're going to believe that God is not God. And he said, maybe the church has abandoned these people. He said, but he has not.
Yes.
And we have got to get on board and begin to think about what he did while he was on earth. Because you think about it now. Jesus, you know, a lot of times people think ministry is just preaching.
Mm-hmm.
Or just singing, or just doing whatever their primary gift is to the body. But think about what Jesus did. Jesus preached all day to the, it says 5,000 men, but we understand there were men, children,
and
women there,
yes,
as well. So we're talking about a crowd that was at least 15,000,
yes,
or more. So after he preached that word and delivered that word to them, the next thing that he said was, he told his disciples, we're going to feed these people.
Yes.
We're going to take care of their needs. So the Lord has put into my heart that it's good for us to preach the gospel.
Yes.
It's good for us to go and sing. And it's good for us to do all the things that he's called us to do, because it's powerful. Like I said, your gift changed my whole life. But God says we have got to touch the lives
right.
of people
That's
to
right.
show them that they have not been abandoned. But God loves them, and it's his desire to bring them into the abundant life, because that's who Jesus is. He is. Like you said, God is love, and Jesus is love. God is Jesus is the God of the abundant life.
Yes.
And where you see people lacking and starving and suffering, that's a sign that Jesus is not able to put his hand there, because we're not putting our hands there.
Yes.
And like you said, we got to get in the trenches. We
yes.
got to get dirty.
Yes.
And we got to begin to show people that God is real and he loves them even in their situation.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God, Miss Deborah.
God.
I'll tell you something. I love what you just said. I love how the Lord grew your ministry from, you said that the Lord said to you, feed the hungry. And so or you went and got bottles of water. And you went out on the street and gave out a bottle of water. And then he said, do more. And so you put a sandwich with that water. And then he said, do more. And you went out and you did more. And you started with just a bottle of water, that thing that you have in your hand.
Right.
And I hear so many people say, well, you know, I don't know where to start. Well, just start right where you are.
Right.
Start with that little mustard seed.
Amen.
And then allow God to bless that and breathe on that and multiply that.
Yeah.
And then do more.
That's
and
it.
Then as he entrusts you with more and you do more, then he will entrust you with some more. And I love how you have just taken that little seed of faith and God has just multiplied it into a huge ministry. Now you also, Deborah, believe the whole word of God that says go into the uttermost parts of the earth.
Exactly.
You are not only ministering to your neighbor, but you are ministering to those, not only those across the street, but those across the sea. Tell us about this international vision that you have and are carrying out.
God is so good.
Yes,
and then the Lord spoke to my heart and he said, yes, you are a missionary. He said, I want you to go. But so I began to do that.
Well, I heard somebody say that you're either a missionary or a mission project.
Oh.
So, you know. Put the shoes on where they fit, okay?
I like that.
Amen. You're either a missionary or a mission project.
That's good. I like that. So one morning I was in prayer. I was praying. And the Lord said, when Jan calls you, the Lord said, when she calls, tell her yes. So I said, okay. So she called me up and she said, I've been called to out to do some missions. And at this point, she was called to go to Canada and to France. And so she said, and I want you to go with me. And I said, okay. And
Dr. Deborah Isom is here to remind you that you can begin again. He whom the Son sets free is free indeed. And if you have invited Jesus into your life and into your heart, every day is a day of new beginnings. And even in spite of what you've done, your past, whatever that looks like, Jesus says you can always begin again. And with his help, he will help you. With Jesus, you can always be successful. He has a plan. It's a plan to prosper you and not to harm you, a plan to give you a hope in the future. And Dr. Deborah Isom knows this so well because she works with people who I can just imagine have said, you know, I felt like giving up. I felt like giving in. I felt like I didn't have any recourse. I'm so glad that you came by. I'm just imagining what they have said to you. Can you tell me some of the things that some people have said as they have encountered Begin Again Ministries?
Yes, you're right, because so many people feel lost. You know, and so frequently people think that it's just the unsaved. But, you know, we encounter people who know the Lord.
Yeah.
You know, and they've been born again. And they feel like, well, you know, why have I been forsaken? What, you know, and the word of God is so intense. But the problem is so many times people, they don't mind giving you the sandwich or the bottle of water. But the real change comes through the word of God. So what happens is we have to go out there and we have to touch those lives. And we have to tell them what the word of God says,
yes.
That God loves you.
Yes.
Because that's where the change takes place. You were just talking about John 17:23, and you're talking about the fact that the Bible says that God loves us as much as he loves Jesus.
Yes, what a life-changing promise.
Exactly, and you were talking about how that scripture actually changed your life. But look, you're Babbie Mason. You are Babbie Mason, which is, you know, in this earth, that's a huge thing to be.
I'm just somebody's wife and somebody's mama, somebody's friend.
And somebody's minister of the gospel that changed lives.
Amen.
Every day. But, you know, that scripture changed her life. Think about that now. If that scripture can change this woman of God's life, think about if we put that scripture in our mouths and
yes.
take it to the homeless.
Yes.
Take it to those who
yes.
are less fortunate. Think about
how it will change their world.
Exactly. And it will change their world. So we have to be so mindful and so clear about the instructions that God has given us. Truly, he said that we should go ye into all the world and preach the gospel. But as we go and as we minister that word, and we have to minister the word of good news, of hope, like what you're talking about, as we go delivering the food, delivering the places for
That's
them
right.
to go.
And you know, when we carry food and water, when we meet their physical needs, they'll listen.
That's right.
They'll listen.
That's right.
Because you had enough compassion to meet their physical need,
exactly.
to give them a bottle of water on a hot summer day and a sandwich. And then they'll sit down and tell you their story.
That's it.
And let you pray for them.
That's right.
And lead them to the Lord.
That's right.
And they'll tell you their story.
Because they don't want your Jesus if you don't have compassion. Mm. Because as you have mentioned, love is an action word. It's a person.
Yes.
And the person of Jesus Christ, he's not going to dwell on the inside of you without giving you his attributes, the attributes of love. So we have to be so mindful of that. But you ask a question. You said, talk about some of the stories that we have encountered. You know, we were out doing breakfast one morning, and we noticed that there was a gentleman. He was just very helpful. I mean, he was just almost helping us organize and just doing all these things. And I just began to talk to him. I was like, because he seemed like he was out of place. He seemed like he shouldn't have been there on those streets. And I just began to talk to him, and he told me that he had, he was a doctor, a medical doctor. And he had been a medical doctor. And,
wow.
And he said that his wife had an affair, and she left him and took their kids. And when that happened, something, he kind of snapped, and he lost his practice, and then he lost his home, and then everything. Mm. You know, so he was moved here to Atlanta and just was living on the street.
Wow.
So you don't know who you're dealing
with. That's right.
With,
you know? You don't know who you're going to encounter.
Exactly.
Out there
exactly.
on those streets.
And you don't know what the need is, but if you talk to people, then you can begin to see what the need is, and then you can offer help to help them to move from one place to another place.
Yes.
Because I'm telling you something. Jesus said he came that we may have life, and that life more abundantly.
That's right.
That means that if you encounter somebody who's not living life abundantly, then that means that the hand of Jesus hasn't been able to be placed in their lives.
That's
and
right.
your hand
That's right.
is that hand.
You are the vehicle.
Exactly.
You actually become the hands of Jesus
Amen.
And the
Amen.
Feet of Jesus
That's
and the
it.
Words of Jesus
That's right.
and the ministry of Jesus.
That's exactly
and, well,
right.
you know, Dr. Deborah Isom, we are out of time, but can
oh,
you give us
goodness.
Some contact information? Give us your like a website where our viewers can contact you and let
yes.
you know that they've seen today's show.
Amen. Website. You can contact us at bamatl.org. Again, that website is bamatl.org. Would you like me to give a phone number?
Sure, if you'd like
you
to.
You can give a phone number, 770-306-1453. And we'd love to hear from you.
Well, Dr. Deborah Isom, thank you again, my friend, for being my very special guest. And what a passionate, powerful woman you are. And she also has a television show here in the station in which we record Babbie's House. And I've seen her so many times on TV. And when I saw her, I felt like immediately like I knew her. But I've just been it's just been such a blessing to be a recipient of this great ministry that God has given you. And you've infected my life in eternal ways. And thank you so very, very much for being on Babbie's House.
Thank you for having
Absolutely.
Me. Thank you for having
and
me.
And thank you, my friend, for watching Babbie's House today. Will you do me a favor and go to Babbie.com? I love to hear from you. I love getting your emails, and I love getting your comments on Facebook and your letters even. So many of you even write letters, and I'm so grateful that you're doing that. Thank you for contacting us. And will you do that, go to Babbie.com today and let me know that you're out there. Well, I love you, and God bless you, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye for now.